guys, right now it's like 3 a.m. here in Cuauhtemoc, Mexico, which I believe it's about 4 a.m. back in Texas. I gotta tell you about this phenomenal thing that just went down. Right now we just finished a 3-day event with the evangelist Juan Carlos Harrigan. He's a guy from Dominican Republic. They asked me to be the singer during his administration. That's why my voice is kind of like this, that, and it's colder up here in Cuauhtemoc than back home in West Texas. So I got a little sore throat because of that. But let me tell you what happened. It's just too cool what happened. I mean, the first night, of course, I was nervous like crazy, but it's just a great time, you know, singing, worshiping God, and miracles started happening. Well, God's the one doing miracles once I watched my singing, and I was just in sync with this guy. And before you know it, people started getting out of wheelchairs and saying, you know what, I don't need my wheelchair anymore, I can walk. The second night, I worked with another band, and we had fun. It started to rain, and of course, we all started praying, you know, Lord, hold back the rain. But the rain kept coming. So then he goes, well, then God has a reason for this rain. And he started telling the people, you know what? If you want your miracle right now, God is raining down on you right now. Receive your miracle. And people started getting healed again. It was pretty cool. And the musicians I was with, we just kept playing in the rain. You know, our instruments were getting wet, but nothing happened. No shorting, nothing. We just kept playing in the rain. It was pretty cool. I was like right next to the drummer. Every time he'd hit the cymbals, you'd see like the splash of the water. Like in some of the music videos. But we're actually playing live in the rain. And nothing happened to the instruments. That was just an awesome move of God. And tonight, well, last night basically, said, because it's 3 a.m, it was just a great time again. And here's just the one thing I just wanted to share. He went down, Harrigan stepped down and started praying for people, and he got lost in the crowd somewhere. And he told us, hey, keep playing. We just worship God, having some fast songs and just enjoying ourselves. And finally, they dismissed the service, the crusade. And people started coming towards the stage. And one lady just came up to me and just started asking for prayer. And I was like, because I'm not the kind of person who just, you know, my ministry is more like I just worship God. Enjoy themselves in that area. But I prayed for her and God touched her. And as I was about to get down the stage, another lady approached me, and she was like holding her daughter's arm was like all limp and kind of like this, and she started telling me, could you pray for my daughter? And I started to think they had me confused with the evangelist. And I was like, how can I tell him, you know, he's over in the crowd? But just something in me, it was just boldness in me, you know, that it's not me who does the miracle, it's God. And then she also, the lady was explaining, and also I have her walking, but it hurts for her to walk, she can't walk. And just something in me was telling me, you know what? I looked at the girl in her eyes, and I asked her, when do you want your miracle? And she looked at me like, what? Excuse me? I'm like, when do you want your miracle? And then she smiled because she understood. She goes, I want it now. And then I said, okay. Give me your hand. She gave me her hand. And I said, conforme tu fe y la fe de tu mamá, you know, and according to your faith and your mother's faith, receive your miracle in Jesus' name. And I said, squeeze my hand. And she squeezed my hand. You know, strength came to her. And she squeezed my hand. And I like, squeeze it harder. And she squeezed it harder. And I'm like, and my mind's like, does it hurt? And she goes, no. And I'm like, all right, well, God gave you strength now follow me. And I jumped out for the stage and I grabbed her hand, like, walk with me. She started walking. And I let her go. She started keep on walking. And I asked her, is the pain still there? And she was like, no, the pain's gone. And I'm like, praise God, because he just did a miracle in your life. And the mom just started bawling and crying. And in my mind, I'm like, oh snap. I'm like, thank you, God. Thank you. It was just a phenomenal thing. I mean, I've never been involved with this. I mean, I have seen it, witnessed it, but you know, I've never really been used by God in that area. Maybe it's just this one time, I don't know. But hey, it really encouraged me. And I just want to share with you guys the revival we had down here in cuauhtemoc. And actually, right now, about an hour, we're about to talk. We're taking off to El Paso. We're taking Harrigan to the airport over there. And he wanted to talk to me. He's got an international ministry like me, and he's thinking about combining forces and see what happens from there. We'll see. Only God can tell what the future is. But hey, we'll see what happens. Well, I probably won't sleep any. I'm too excited, but I'll try to at least lay down in sweet dreams. So until next time, I'm your friend Josa, saying much love and many blessings.